Breaking news. Republican Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene just wrapping up a town hall amid the growing uproar over numerous conspiracy theories she has spread. And tonight, she was still spreading conspiracy theories amid calls for her to be removed from the Education Committee in Congress.
We had been preparing very hard, quite a few of us in the House and some of our senators, to object on January 6th to election fraud and objecting in six different states. We had done a lot of work in our preparation, talked to a lot of people, looked at a lot of evidence that I think still needs to be looked at and should be presented in court. I truly believe that. You see, this wasn't a conspiracy of several people that got together and created a story. This is literally thousands of people in different states and different voting precincts, different counties, and they all signed these affidavits.
I just want to make a point here that this is crazy, okay? By the way, that evidence she's talking about doesn't exist. There were more than 60 court cases. Whatever was out there was presented. 61 of them failed, okay? There's nothing there. I hate to have to say it again, but when someone says stuff like that, it's just the facts need to be put out there. Meanwhile, the people in that room, inside, without masks, not socially distanced, listening to her, are listening to these lies, right? And she's in Congress, and she's getting put on committees. And so not only is there this conspiracy lie that she's putting out there, she's now trying to delete dozens of old social media posts that are getting the scrutiny even of Kevin McCarthy's office. It's saying they're unacceptable. You know, today we actually found a posting where she said lasers from space caused California wildfires. And CNN's K-File discovered these comments from Nancy Pelosi from 2018.
She's guilty of treason. It's a crime punishable by death. Is what treason is. Nancy Pelosi is guilty of treason.
Martin Savidge is out front at the town hall. It's in Dallas, Georgia. So, Martin, what are you hearing from her constituents about her past comments, conspiracy theories? By the way, you know, she's also said there's no evidence that a plane flew into the Pentagon on 9/11. I mean, there's some of this stuff is just crazy.
Right, and crazies. The real world here. But the thing to point out is that for those who showed up at the town hall meeting tonight, they believe it. They believe just about all of it. In fact, two things you could get from this meeting tonight. One, it's clear that the Congresswoman herself feels emboldened. In fact, the more that she is attacked, and that's the way she describes it, the more that she feels she is in the right. And what is obvious by about the 60 to 70 people that were in attendance, none of whom were wearing masks, they all believe it too. We're only about 40 miles outside of the city of Atlanta. This is the town of Dallas. We weren't allowed inside that meeting. It was made clear by law enforcement and by the Congresswoman's office that we weren't going to be getting in. We could listen via Facebook feed. But what you find out is that the mindset of her mind matches to many of those who listen. And I point out this conversation I had with a gentleman in downtown Dallas just before this old town hall meeting tonight. Listen in. She was not a congresswoman at the time, but she is your congresswoman now. And I just ask if that is the right way for a congresswoman to act.
Well, like you just said, she wasn't a congresswoman right then. And I done a lot of things in my past that I ain't proud of now, you know. And but I'm not going to run for Congress, and I'm not going to run for a senator.
You haven't changed your mind one bit about her, have you?
Not a bit. I like her.
Is there anything that would change your mind about her? You know, we had been talking about David Hogg at that time and about how she had been running down the street trying to accost this young man who had survived that deadly Parkland High School shooting. And that's the reaction he had. Poisoned minds. That's about the only thing that you can really think of here. People have been so inundated with the conspiracy theories and with what they believe is the truth, even though you point out fact, even though you come at them time and time again and say that that is wrong, to them, it's not. It's a disturbing and troubling thing to witness. And it's clear that the congresswoman is happy to go along with it.
So it's really amazing. I think we've gotten to a point you have to accept, right? It's an alternate reality. They're not facts. They're not alternate facts, right? It is an alternate reality, and it is not based on facts. Thank you very much, Martin Savidge. You know, to go there, it's amazing, right? No one is even press allowed in to where Marty was, and that had to watch on the Facebook feed, right? Because they're not even allowing the press. Out front now, Republican State Senator from Georgia, Chuck Huffstetler. He represents many of the same voters from North Georgia that Congresswoman Greene represents, and we've had the opportunity to speak before. Senator, let me just ask you about that constituent first. You know, the gentleman that you just heard speaking to Martin Savidge, right? He defends the congresswoman's past comments. I don't know what specifically that was about, whether, you know, when she went after the teen, right, whose friends had died in the school shooting, the plane, whatever it might have been. But his thing was, I had bad things in my past, too. And then he said there's nothing she could do that would make him change his support. What's your reaction?
It's sad, and Dallas isn't in my state senate district, but it's sad when you see this kind of reaction from these people. The fact that they don't want to look at reality. And, you know, we don't treat this behavior the same in the Georgia legislature. We had several chair removed this year for putting debunked theories out there that were clearly not there. We had a House member evicted for not following COVID protocol this week and his office space taken away from him. We had a member that lost his chair last year for racist comments. We had another member several years ago that was given the choice to resign or be expelled. And we as Republicans need to have certain standards.
They don't have them on Capitol Hill. They don't seem to have the same ones on Capitol Hill. She just got committee assignments that you have.
I think there's some intimidation there.
So let me ask you, because, you know, the reason you and I spoke, before you were on the show, you were very early to say Joe Biden beat Donald Trump and was the president that he had won. You said it was important for you and other officials to tell the truth. But we just heard Congresswoman Greene right now, right? January 28th, we have a new president. She just, I don't know if you heard her, right? But she just said that they want to present this evidence in court. There were thousands of people in all these states with this whole conspiracy. I mean, at this point, what do you do? There were 60 or 70 people in that room. And as Martin said, every single one of them believes this stuff. And it's just a lie.
Well, fortunately, there's a lot of people that don't. And in my state Senate district, she did not get the majority vote. But it's distressing, the false lies that go on social media that travel so much faster and get believed. Yeah. And, you know, when you're advocating violence against congressional members, when, you know, you're having parents have to listen to you say that, no, their child didn't really die, it was staged. It's totally outrageous. It's not acceptable. And the Republican Party needs to take care of it.
Well, I appreciate your speaking out. I know it's not easy to do it, because I know that there are people who come after you for doing it. But I hope that there are people in Washington that hear you, in the Republican Party, that hear you and step up and do the right thing. Senator, I appreciate your time.
Thanks. I appreciate it.